Hi, I'm Alan Thomas from Hiscox. We're here at the Royal Institution where we're hosting a debate on entrepreneurship, art or science. So we've invited some of the leading and most exciting brains in UK business here to have just that debate. Entrepreneurship, is it an innate skill or is it something that can be learned?
I'm Vivian Parry, I'm a science writer and broadcaster and I'm hosting the debate.
So that's our debate tonight. Are they born or are they made? So the Hiscox research they did said of SME entrepreneurs said 53% thought their talent was innate.
Hi, I'm Max McEwen. I'm an expert in innovation and strategy. And I'll be arguing that entrepreneurship comes from nature.
So one of the things that I would say about this innate business, the science, the art business of being an entrepreneur, is that taking the big leap and having the great idea and seeing it through is really quite important. And it's the thing you can't be taught in business schools at the moment. The entrepreneur's view of the future is really quite important because it's different to the way other people think. They don't believe the future is predictable. They do believe they can make the future. And this comes up time and time again in the psychological traits that suggest successful entrepreneurs. Everything for an entrepreneur is an opportunity. They tend to be creative, open, imaginative, philosophical, intellectual, complex, deep, unenvious and relaxed, essentially open. So the entrepreneurs view risk in a very different way to the average person, especially to managers. So essentially the entrepreneur works on this basis. He sees an opportunity, then he grabs the opportunity. He sees another opportunity, then he grabs it. So it is true to say that in the realm of human affairs exists an entrepreneurial method, and that is much like the scientific method. So you can kind of codify it, except that the personality traits, the sort of innate bit, the pattern recognition, the risk sort of pleasure, that's different, and you'll never be able to codify that. So entrepreneurship is an art, and it comes from a set of abilities that cannot be easily imitated.
I'm Daniel Jones from the Lean Enterprise Academy, and I'm arguing for nurture.
I've been seeing companies transform by teaching and by learning by doing. The scientific method, basically the method of controlled experiments. Let's understand the problem, really understand the problem, not just the symptom. Let's pursue a set of experiments to try and solve that problem and see which ones work. Check actually what worked and what didn't. And entrepreneurship is not a science, and it's not learned from theory. It's actually a practice. It's much more like medicine. So that is, I think, something absolutely that you can teach to anybody who is willing to be taught. The entrepreneurial idea has to be translated into a sustaining and sustainable business. And that isn't easy, and that those things can be learnt by doing, by carrying out experiments, as I said before. The existing business model built upon the economies of scale and mass production and so on is broken, is fundamentally broken, and has reached the limits of its usefulness. And so the opportunities for no longer trying to improve the functioning of big factories, big distribution centres, but finding completely new business models that deliver those services in a very different way, the timing for that is absolutely right. So I believe actually a great deal of the skills necessary to make an entrepreneurial idea a sustainable business reality can actually be learned if people are open to being taught.
My name's Steve Ridgway, I'm the Chief Executive of Virgin Atlantic, and I'm going to be debating for nature.
There's a lot of natural entrepreneurship that goes on, but there's no doubt when an organisation gets the size we are now, there's also quite a lot of nurturing that happens as well. Some of the smart things that entrepreneurs do that, yes, they can go off and make these big changes, these big leaps, if you like, into something that just they had no experience about before, but they are smart enough to actually, certainly in the case of the airline industry, to make sure that they bring people in alongside them who can deal with all the very real technical challenges and the legal challenges and the compliance challenges of running an airline. And I think you'll see in a minute that you can tell some differences there between certainly the way I think Branson has built his businesses in a very technically challenging area like this, but at the same time remained a very free spirit to do what he wanted and make sure he built an organisation that reflected that. And another feature that I think comes out so strongly is just sheer unadulterated bravery. And I think one thing I've noticed, certainly in the way that someone like Branson operates, is that they are enormously brave. They are incredible poker players. I thought you were saying, Max, they do bet the farm frequently. And I think one of the reasons that probably many of his companies have survived, and certainly Virgin Atlantic has survived, is that he will always be out here in extreme and wanting to really go for it. And there'll be other people in the company, probably the finance director, who will be over here. And you finish up somewhere in the middle, driving the business very hard, but making sure it doesn't fall off a cliff. If you've got a hard-charging organisation where you're taking risks, you can also deal with bad things as well. And that seems to me to be another characteristic of entrepreneurs and entrepreneurial businesses. They don't just stultify and then fall over and die.
So, an art or a science, ladies and gentlemen? Those who think that entrepreneurship is an art, put up your hands. Those who think it's a science? A small, but obviously quality band.
At Hiscox, we insure over 100,000 SME businesses, and we live and breathe the risk that those entrepreneurs that form those businesses face every day.